Hey everyone, Shaedow here, and welcome to another Marvel Contest of Champions video. So Gambit and Tigra Arena, round one is over. I just went for milestones, but we're going to take a look at the leaderboards and see if we see any names that we recognize. I know I'm going to see one name that I recognize because he let me know that he actually managed to get the champion. All right, so let's go ahead over here. Yeah, Spider-Ham. Hamming it up. All right, let's go over here. And as I said, I just went for milestones. As you see, I got the 5,000 shards. You'll see how much I went for to get that. And just milestones all around. All right. First up, from left to right, 4-star basic, Tigra. There's a Black Devil. Congratulations. Now, people were asking me about Tigra, you know, how good she is. Black Gamer, congratulations. And she's good, but she has a high skill cap. Now, I don't know enough about her to be confident in telling someone whether they should rank her up or awaken her. But from what I've seen and just the little bit that I played around with, she takes a pretty high skill cap to use well. Now, whether it's worth it or not, is another story. You don't see too many people using Tigra. And the ones who do love her, they've put in the time, they've acquired the skill to use her quite well. So definitely a good champion, and one that I know a lot of people that if they, you know, enjoy a little challenge and learning to play a champion well, they love her. I'm not so much that way. I like things to be pretty straightforward and relatively easy. Probably my age telling on me. I like things nice and easy. When I was younger, it was different. I liked it spicy, and I'd go for them hard to use champions just so that I could show off and for the challenge of it. I remember playing a game. And in this game, there was a class called Sorcerer. The Sorcerer class was pretty flimsy at first. Very difficult to level up. And really, you didn't want to try leveling him up by yourself. That's how bad he was early on. And I went and chose that character. And I would do as much as I could on my own. It was very slow going because I couldn't take on things that were even my level. And sometimes if I got a chance to get into a group, then I would get into a group. But when I got my guy up there, I got to the place where I was considered probably either the most powerful or the second most powerful. All right, and that felt good. There was basically me and another guy went at it. We actually had a duel, but you can't really tell, you know, a lot when it comes to how powerful a champion is or a character is from a duel, but you can get a pretty good idea. And I beat him. Now, mind you, he was a melee character. Normally, a melee character has a huge advantage, especially in a quick duel, against the way that they usually implement magic-type characters. But in this game, I knew what I was doing. I, you know, did a whole bunch of special quests. Once I got to the place where I could do stuff on my own, there was an ability I had that was a teleport, but it was an uncontrolled teleport. So I would use that, and I would end up sometimes in an area that had some pretty beefy guys, but it would bypass certain things. Like, you know, I might have teleported in an area where I could just go right to a boss instead of having to deal with all of the minions and you need a group and everything. And so I would be able to take down some pretty big guys and get some really good gear. And so when I went up against him, he really couldn't do any damage. I had a shield that, you know, he could do damage to, but I could renew it. And I had a lot of mana, you know, which meant I could keep renewing it for quite a while. Now, he, being a melee, he could take health. You know, he had health potions and things like that. But so did I. But honestly, if my shield went down, I probably wouldn't have lasted all that long. But my shield didn't go down. And so he was just like, wow. And a lot of people didn't realize just how powerful that class was until they saw that, because it was actually an event. You know, people were like, oh man, he's going to go up against this guy and blah, blah, blah. And a lot of people made sorcerers because of me. Fuzz, congratulations. Or Fayoz, I don't remember how to pronounce your name, but congratulations. The Integral, congratulations. Hopefully I didn't miss, while I was rambling on about that story, hopefully I didn't miss too many people. If I did, just leave a comment, let me know what score you put up and what ranking you got. All right, so that's it. Now for the last one, we've got Gambit, 5-star. You see, I put up 22 million. That's pretty much what I put up every time if I can to get the 5,000 five-star shards. And so far, I have not missed putting up scores like that. All right, Black Devil, congratulations again. Rank 4. All right. Now, the reason I went off on that tangent is because that sorcerer is the same as how I see a champion like Tigra, where she may not seem to be really powerful, but if you learn what you need to do with her and you get good at it, then she's actually really good. So basically, she's really good in the hands of someone who is skilled enough to use her. Black Gamer, congratulations. But if you're not planning on, it's similar to Ghost, if you're not planning on putting in the time to learn how to play them well, then don't even bother. Ace Newt, congratulations. Let's see. And I know already one. Ben Riley, congratulations. Enjoy. Let's see. Anybody else? I already know one, but I don't know who all was even going for him. He just recently got a rework. He is much better than he was. Clutch Turkey! Congratulations, man. Yeah, he's much better than he was. The Integral again, congratulations. And I do like the rework. I don't know if I'll be using him a whole lot. Coat Hanger, congratulations. But when I do find myself having to use him, I'm no longer upset or worried. And that's mainly in the arena, which is where I use him. There's the name, Demons. Now, is that Demons Divide? Is that how you say your name, Demons Divide? But congratulations, 119. He sent me a screenshot. And I think he put up, he said like 27 million. So, yeah. Gambit went pretty low. All right. Let's see. And everyone on the leaderboards that you're seeing here, they got the champion. So we'll only see the top 200. But the top 300 actually get the champion. All right, trying to see to make sure I don't miss anyone else. I'm not even sure who all went for him. definitely not a bad pickup. This is only the first round, and I know a lot of people like me don't go for a champion round one. They wait, see what he went for, then they decide whether they can put up a score that's likely to get him round two. So definitely leave a comment and let folks know what score you put up. I'm not going for him. I already have him. And he's awakened. But let people know what you put up so that they can make a better informed decision whether they want to go for him round two. But he's definitely a good pickup. If you don't have him and you're able to put up at least 30 million, then I say go for it. He is definitely worth that easy pickup, or easy if you have the roster, of course. But that's going to do it, guys. Thank you all for watching the video. Feel free to hit that like button if you enjoyed it. Leave a comment. Let me know what you thought of the video. Let me know the scores you put up. Let me know what your ranking was. If you haven't given me a subscription, leave a or give me a subscription. But what I was going to say is sometimes YouTube does not send out the notifications on my videos, on my live streams, but you can follow me on Twitch, Twitter, or even Facebook. And you can also join my Discord server. All the information that you need is in the description. So there's no reason that you have to miss any of my notifications or videos or live streams. All right, so take care, and you all have a blessed day.